I've been using Mint Mobile as my personal provider for the past year and a half now, and I realized I haven't done an updated review of them. A lot has changed since I first tried Mint way back in 2017. They've added new features, allow faster data speeds, and are now owned by Ryan Reynolds, who recently left all Mint customers a voicemail because, quite frankly, I think he's bored out of his mind.
Go to mintmobile.com for all the details. Mostly, though, I'm a little bored.
The poor guy. Anyway, I now think Mint is one of the best deals out there. Let me explain. Mint is a prepaid carrier known as an MVNO, or Mobile Virtual Network Operator. All this means is instead of building Mint cell towers across the country and creating their own network, Mint operates virtually on another network for coverage. That network is T-Mobile. Mint is known for disrupting the industry by offering insanely cheap plans starting at just 15 bucks a month for 3 gigs of data, all thanks to their bulk pricing model. You sign up for service by choosing how much data you want, either 3, 8, or 12 gigabytes, and then you sign up for either a 3, 6, or 12 month plan. Naturally, the longer you sign up for, the better price you get, and the more you save on your cell phone bill. You can get 3 gigs for as low as $15, 8 gigs for $20, and 12 gigs for $25 with the 12-month options. These prices are also available as intro offers for new customers. The longer-term plans are great if you're staying in one location for a longer time, such as if you're a student in boarding school or college, or maybe you're a study abroad student visiting the United States for a semester, or you know you just won't be moving soon. And if you are moving or traveling, you just want to check to make sure T-Mobile coverage is good in the area you're headed. In my case, I know I get good T-Mobile coverage, so I feel confident signing up for a 12-month plan to get the best price possible. You'll enjoy coverage on the T-Mobile network along with fast data speeds and performance. And this is actually the first area Mint had a big improvement in since my original review. Previously, Mint offered a 20 megabit per second data speed cap. This was actually still plenty fast, but Mint has since removed the speed cap, allowing you to get full speed LTE data on the T-Mobile network. Not only that, Mint secretly supports T-Mobile's 5G network. I tested them out on my Galaxy S20 Plus 5G, thank you Samsung for the great name, and I was surprised to see the 5G icon in my status bar. I ran some speed tests around Boston, and I can confirm T-Mobile's 5G network is supported on Mint Mobile. The co-founder of Mint Mobile has confirmed on Reddit that 5G support will officially be coming later this year, but until then, it was working perfectly fine for me on my S20 Plus, and it should work for you if you have a 5G compatible phone. You may have also heard that T-Mobile has officially merged with Sprint. This is going to help make the T-Mobile network even better, offering more bands of 5G, offering faster and better performance. Honestly, I think this is a huge win with T-Mobile, and therefore Mint, which uses T-Mobile for coverage. The second big area Mint saw improvements in was with the experience for iPhone users. Previously, you had to enter what are called APN settings, or access point name settings. These configure how your phone connects to the cellular network and enable features like group messaging, picture messaging, and cellular data to work properly on your device. You had to enter Mint's custom APN settings to get everything to work, but you only had to do it once. Still, this was a hassle and potentially confusing for people unfamiliar with this. Thankfully, since September 2018, Mint made it so these settings are automatically configured for iPhone users. All you need to do is pop in your Mint Mobile SIM card and everything will be set up and working properly. Some Android users may still need to enter the custom APN settings, and if that's you, I have a video tutorial on how to do that. The third area Mint saw huge improvements in were their features. They offer completely full feature service on the T-Mobile network, which I am super thankful for. This includes support for visual voicemail on iPhone and Android. You get voice over LTE, Wi-Fi calling, the mobile hotspot, and as I mentioned, 5G access. Mint also added support for international calling and data roaming. You can add international roaming credit to your account, and Mint will deduct from this credit in a pay-per-use basis for minutes, text, and data. While I don't recommend Mint for international use, I'm pleased this is an option and it's available if you need it in a pinch. And finally, there is the Mint mobile application. This actually recently got a major redesign and I kinda love it. You can now see your remaining data front and center. Previously, you had to tap to check your remaining balance, and now, bam, it's right there in front of you. You can also more easily manage your plan. You can quickly see when your next payment is due and how much it is. You also have the option to switch plans. With Mint, you can upgrade your plan at any time, even in the middle of your billing cycle. You'll just pay a prorated difference between the current plan you signed up for and your new plan. This was helpful for myself last summer when I realized I needed more than 3 gigs of data, so I was easily able to upgrade to the 8 gig plan and just pay the difference. The changes took effect almost immediately and I was able to enjoy that extra 5 gigs of data. Unfortunately, if you are looking to downgrade your plan, the changes will take effect on your next billing cycle. Getting support also got easier too. Mint now has a dedicated support page where you can start a conversation with an agent or visit Mint's FAQ section for answers to common questions. If you opt for the chat support, which I tried out, you'll be greeted by a bot that can answer common questions. You can tap on suggested quick replies to find the answer you're looking for, or if you ask a question the bot doesn't know the answer to, it'll pull in a human representative that you can chat with. Up top, you'll see your position in a queue if the support is crowded and your estimated wait time. When I chatted with support, I was connected in just a few minutes and I asked the simple question of how to enter the APN settings on an Android phone, which, judging from the popularity of my video tutorial, seemed like an appropriate question you may ask. Oddly, the first rep disconnected for some reason, but the second rep was nice, quick to respond, and helpful. He provided me with all the information I needed. Every support experience will be different, but I do think it's great Mint is providing this live chat support directly within their application. The final tab in the app is the account tab. Here you can add more data, either 1 gig or 3 gigs. You can add international roaming credit, change your payment method, view your transaction history, and of course, manage your account preferences. Overall, I think the update improves the design and functionality of the app and makes the Mint experience that much better. And that's why I use Mint as my personal provider. They have full speed uncapped LTE data on the T-Mobile network with support for 5G coverage on compatible phones. APN settings are now automatically configured for iPhone users, and Android phones will get a text message to quickly set them up. Major features like voice over LTE, Wi-Fi calling, and the personal hotspot are fully supported on Mint, and they have a clean new app design. Mint offers premium features at a budget price, and honestly, that's why I use them as my personal provider. If you live in an area with good T-Mobile coverage and don't need unlimited data, I recommend you give Mint Mobile a try. I think they can help reduce your cell phone bill, and listen, that's what I'm all about. If you're interested in trying Mint Mobile, consider using the link in the video description to sign up, as it helps support the channel at no cost to you, and I greatly appreciate it. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful, and subscribe for more videos like this one.